Hello, this is Chad with Syncfusion. In this video, I'm talking about the Syncfusion JavaScript Schedule control. Here is our product page. This is public. You can come to it and look at it yourself. And the schedule control is written in TypeScript, so it's going to support all of these platforms. Down here is some text talking about why you should use our schedule control. And I'm not going to read text on the screen. That just seems a bit silly. So I'm going to jump straight into our samples. This is our overview sample. This is the default one. This shows a couple things about different views we have set up. You can determine grouping. You can check, uncheck grouping. We support all that here to you. A couple things people like to see is our linking to Google Calendar. This particular sample, we do that simply by doing this. And then we get our Syncfusion data manager to actually handle those AJAX calls for you. Now, you don't have to use the data manager. You can just bind to some local JSON data source. That's totally acceptable. The data manager just makes life a little bit easier for those of you that don't already have this set up. See, a couple of the things that people like to see is drag and drop. So over here, this is our schedule control here in the middle. And on the right, we just have a simple list. And I can take this list of objects, put it over here, and drop it to an event. Now, you don't have to make this pop-up happen. We do it here because it's a sample, and we got to show all the cool stuff. But you save it, and it shows up here. And then you can do the editing. You can move it as you wish, like that. Our multiple events. This is actually pretty cool. I'm selecting a couple of events here with control and click, and then I'm going to drag them. So now I have all these dragged, and when I drag it, it does automatically accommodate the end of the week and roll into the next week, which is kind of slick, I think. Okay. Now, variety of views here. I like looking at the individual view settings. What we have here is we have group A and group B, and we're looking at a month view. This is what I want to show. I want to show view intervals. So view intervals here, we are looking at 2 weeks right now set up, or 3 days, for example. And the way we do that, here in the source, we step in, we can set up 3 intervals to the day view, 2 intervals to the week view, or 4 intervals to the month view. Now, multiple resources. I like to show the room scheduler for this. It's fun. We have a lot of rooms set here. This on the left is just a grid. You can put as many columns here as you wish, and this is just bound to your data source. And on the right, you have appointments that we're putting against that, or events. You can drag these. Now, as I move it, this board meeting is going to become blue because all the events for the Nestle cabin are blue. You can show different work days. For example, here, Alice here, this is Alice. Alice only works 3 days. Will works 4, and Robson actually does a full week of work, or at least scheduled for a full week of work. We can do groupings. If you want to do groupings via timeline, for example, we can set up so you can group it here. So project 1 has these folks in it, and if I don't want to see them, I can collapse it. Templates. So the way it's set up, each of these is a cell, and the cell can have any little bit, any JavaScript template you care to put in here. Okay. Tooltips. You can customize a tooltip to be some JavaScript template as well. And it can be whatever you like there based upon the event. You can pull the data out and change the template. The actual editor template, the thing that pops up. So let's pull this up. This is customizable. So this is not anything that we've seen before. Any of our examples here. You can change this to be, again, this is just a JavaScript template. It can be whatever you like in there. It doesn't have to be data that's bound to the event. You can have extra fields in there. And then on the save event, take that data and do as you need throughout your application. You can change your time scale. Time scale. We're doing intervals. So intervals, slots, yeah, these are two different things. But intervals and slots. Right now we have a 60-minute interval, so it's 10 to 11. If I make this 30 minutes, then we now have 5 to 5:30, 30-minute time slots. And if I want to make these slots here to actually be small. Let's say I want 10 minute slots. I do 3 slots on a 30 minute interval, gives me 10 minute intervals on my schedule here. You can customize the header bar is what I want to click on. So you can put custom content up here. We have today, then we have a cute little picture over here. You can make events read-only. So if you don't want to be able to edit this, you can't do anything to it because it's read-only. We can export to Excel. It just gives a list of all these appointments are going to show up in the list. And I've done it before, so you see that. So here's our list of all that. Okay. We can import or export to ICS or Outlook. And keyboard interactions. This is the last thing people like to see. Here we go. These are all the keyboard interactions that you can do with our schedule control. And please, if you think anything here is going to be helpful to you as you build your application, come. You can download. You can try this for free. Just go get it on NPM. You get your license key here at our websites. Actually, free trial. You can get your license key so you can put it in your application, have it run, let us know what you think. Thank you for watching.